The Sanctified Life, Chapter 5, Daniel in the Lion's Den. When Darius took possession of the throne of Babylon, he at once proceeded to reorganize the government. He set over the kingdom 120 princes and over these three presidents, of whom Daniel was first. Daniel 6, verses 1 and 2. And Daniel was preferred above the presidents and princes, because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king thought to set him over the whole realm. Verse 3. The honors bestowed upon Daniel excited the jealousy of the leading men of the kingdom. The presidents and princes sought to find occasion for complaint against him, but they could find none occasion nor fault. For as much as he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him. Verse 4. What a lesson is here presented for all Christians. The keen eyes of jealousy were fixed upon Daniel day after day. Their watching was sharpened by hatred, yet not a word or act of his life could they make appear wrong. And still he made no claim to sanctification, but he did that which was infinitely better. He lived a life of faithfulness and consecration. The more blameless the conduct of Daniel, the greater was the hatred excited against him by his enemies. They were filled with madness because they could find nothing in his moral character or in the discharge of his duties upon which to base a complaint against him. Then said these men, "We shall not find any occasion against this Daniel, except we find it against him concerning the law of his God." Verse 5. Three times a day Daniel prayed to the God of heaven. This was the only accusation that could be brought against him. A scheme was now devised to accomplish his destruction. His enemies assembled at the palace and besought the king to pass a decree that no person in the whole realm should ask anything of either God or men except of Darius the king for the space of 30 days, and that any violation of this edict should be punished by casting the offender into the den of lions. The king knew nothing of the hatred of these men towards Daniel, and did not suspect that the decree would in any way injure him. Through flattery, they made the monarch believe it would be greatly to his honor to pass such an edict. With a smile of satanic triumph upon their faces, they come forth from the presence of the king and rejoice together over the snare which they have laid for the servant of God. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 5, Daniel in the Lion's Den.